Here you have got only 4 points, and if the question appears for 3 marks, then you need 2 more marks. No, sorry, 2 more points. No, for that, first of all, you have to write for this question. If you are asked to write the features of social stratification, then in your first point, you define what is social stratification. Okay. So first, what you have to do, you should define what is social stratification. Then you have to write the features of social stratification. Four. So did you understand me here, children? So at the end of the lesson also, you have a question. What are the features of social stratification? Okay. So they. For this question also, you have the same habit. Okay, first you write the definition of social stratification, then you write all the 4 points. Any doubts here, children? Any doubts? If you have doubt, raise hand. Otherwise, let us continue. Okay. So then yesterday I have sent you the notes. Have you all written that in your workbook? I have told you to write it in your workbook. For social studies, you need a fair notebook to write the question and answers, and a workbook to copy down the main points of the lessons. Okay. So I hope you all have written. Have you all written? Say yes or no by raising your hand. Completed writing? Okay. Anish, switch on your video. Anish, tell me which article of our constitution gives education as the fundamental right to the children from 6 to 14 years. Which article of our constitution gives that right, Anish? Anish, can you hear me? Anish, am I audible?
Yes, Mataji.
Yes. Tell me, which article of our constitution gives that right? Education as the fundamental right.
Article 21.
Is it Article 21? Preeti Gowda, is he right?
No.
21. Yes, it is
21A.
Exactly. It is Article 21A. Okay. Now Vaishnavi GM. Vaishnavi GM, you tell me by which amendment to our constitution this article was inserted. Article 21A was inserted to the constitution by which amendment? Vaishnavi GM. Yesterday I have mentioned, no? Vaishnavi GM, am I audible? Anurag? Anurag? Neha Aregde. Neha Aregde. Who knows the answer? Raise your hand. Which amendment to our constitution has inserted Article 21A? Sinchana Bhatt. Sinchana D. Bhatt.
86th amendment.
Very good. Okay. So 86th amendment to our constitution has inserted Article 21A. Okay. Next. So Sinchana Bhatt Galimani. Tell me, which article of our constitution provides the right to the minority section to establish their educational institution. Sinchana S. Bhatt.
Article.
Very good. Article.
Article 30.
Yes, Article 30 is the correct answer. Article 30 provides for establishment of educational institutions of minority section. Okay. Okay. Then next, B.G. Shaman. B.G. Shaman, which article of our constitution declares that it is the duty of the government? It is the duty of the government to provide education, free and compulsory education to the children from 6 to 14 years. Shaman. Okay, Anurag, you didn't answer that time. Now try. Jeevan? Jeevan? Jeevan, can you hear me? Say yes or no. Even if you do not know the answer, tell me. Can you hear me, Jeevan? Okay, Kishore. Kishore?
Yes, Mataji.
Which article of our constitution says that it is the duty of the government to provide free and compulsory education to the children? Do you remember?
Article 29.
Article? No, you are not right.
29.
No, no, it is not right. Article 29 gives the right to protect cultural rights to minority section. So, Neeraj.
Mataji.
Yes, tell me, which article?
Mataji, Article
45. Thank you. Neeraj, you are correct. Article 45 says like that. Okay. Then, what about Article 46? What does Article 46 say? Now, I want you to raise your hand.
Kavya Rashmi Brahati.
Brahati, you try. What does Article 46 say?
Article 46 says the government to support the education interest to schedule caste and tribe.
Very good. Okay. Very good. Article 46 says that it's the duty of the government to protect the educational interest of scheduled caste and scheduled tribe. So, you might have understood why am I repeating this one, why am I giving more importance for these articles, for this question, okay? So, you can expect a question for one mark also. You can expect a question for multiple choice also from this section. And all over, you can expect a question for 3 marks also, okay? You have to write all the articles which we have discussed in our previous period. Did you understand? Okay, now let us move on for today's topics, children. So, first of all, forms of a social stratification, then features of social stratification. Yesterday, I have not sent the notes on this topic and I have not even shared the screen for you. Okay, but it is directly given in the book. That is why I hope that you will take it from the textbook. Now, social stratification meaning you have understood, and this social stratification has led to inequality in the society. And because of this inequality in the society, weaker section of the society were exploited by the superior or the stronger section of the society. That we have seen. In the next part of this lesson, we are going to study about one of such weaker sections which was exploited very badly. And nowadays, government has taken many steps for removing that problem. and to some extent it has been successful. So the section of the society which has been very badly exploited is untouchables. So in the next part of our lesson, we are going to concentrate on untouchables, untouchability. Okay, so where it has got its origin, then what is it based on, what are the problems faced by untouchables, then which great leaders of India have fought for the rights of these untouchables, and finally what are the steps taken by our constitution and what are the steps taken by our government to solve the problem of untouchability. I hope you all have got your textbook in your hand. Okay, open your textbook, children. So this is general topic. We will have a discussion. Open your textbook. I will ask a few questions for you. Open your textbook. You have to open page number 82. Open page number 82. Did you open page number 82? I have asked you a question. You have to raise your hand if you have opened. Page number 82. You have a heading called Untouchability, a Social Evil. You don't have the textbook, children. Okay, now let me know. How many of you have not got your textbook with you now, as of now? Others, leave your hand down. How many of you have not got the textbook in your hand? Now, I will ask you a few questions. You have to find the answer from the textbook and tell me. Okay. Now, first question is, untouchability has got its, where can you find the beginning of untouchability? Where did this untouchability begin? It is the major problem of Indian society. It was. Okay. Bhuvana?
Period.
Yes. Untouchability has got its origin in Vedic period. Okay. In the Vedic period, you can find untouchability. It was started during that period. Okay. Then, next one. Untouchability, it was formed during Vedic period, no? So it is based on which system? Which system practiced by Indian society led to untouchability? Nikhil Hegde.
Four Varna system.
Four Varna system. Untouchability has its base in four Varna system. Okay. So, Varna system, it was started during Vedic period. Untouchability has got its origin in Varna system. And this Varna system, it is found during Vedic period itself. Okay. Then afterwards, next one is, this Varna system is based on which theory? On which theory is Varna system based? Nitin Shetty?
It's based on karma theory.
Karma theory. Okay. What do you mean by karma? Karma means what? Siri? Siri, what do you mean by karma?
Actually, karma means works.
Yes, exactly. Karma means works. Okay. Next, what are the four Varnas of Varna system? Four Varnas of Varna system.
Nivedita.
Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra.
Very good. Okay, thank you. Next, what was the work assigned to Brahmins? What was the work assigned to Brahmins? Yashaswini?
Study, teaching, participation in yagnas, etc.
Yes, studying. They were scholars. Brahmins were scholars. So they had to study. They had to expertise themselves. Then they have to teach the children. They have to guide the kings. Okay. Then afterwards, they have to conduct yajnas and yagas for the welfare of the country, kingdom. Okay. Then what was the work of Kshatriyas? Ashwit, what was the work of Kshatriyas?
Political administration.
Political administration, correct. Okay. So, political administration was the work of Kshatriyas. Then what about Vaishyas? What about Vaishyas? What was the work of Vaishyas? Anvit?
That is business.
Yes, business. Okay. Carrying on business, trade, commerce, that was the work given to these people. Okay, Vaishyas. And finally, Sumuk. Sumuk, tell me, what was the work given to these people? Shudras.
Manual laborer.
Manual laborers. Okay. So carrying out manual labor, laboring, that was the work, was work assigned to these people. Okay. Shudras, four varnas. Then finally, there was another varna called Panchamas. Okay. So these Panchamas, they had to carry the night soil, means excretes of human beings. They had to carry the dead animals. So the work which was not done by all the other four varnas, it had to be done by whom? These Panchamas. And they were called what, children? Untouchables. Okay. Yes. Then these untouchables, they were called Harijana by Mahatma Gandhi. But where did they get the name? Scheduled caste and scheduled tribe. Now we call these people as scheduled caste people and scheduled tribe people, no? Where did they get that name? So in the textbook only you have the answer, but let me tell you the answer for you now. So, yes. Kripa. Kripa. Kripa, did you find the answer there?
Yes.
Tell me.
Indian Government Act of 1950.
Exactly. Okay. So when British government, or when British were ruling us in the year 1935, for administration purpose, they have passed an act, and it is called Government of India Act 1935 or Indian Government Act 1935. So this Government of India Act 1935, about this we are going to study in detail in our history lesson. But here for the time being, let us know that Indian Government Act 1935, Government of India Act 1935, it gave the name as, so, scheduled caste and scheduled tribe to these untouchables. Okay. Then we have to discuss about two great leaders of India. You all know that Mahatma Gandhiji and B.R. Ambedkar, they fought very hard for the rights of whom? These untouchables. So Mahatma Gandhiji has told that untouchability is a stigma on the caste system of Hindu society. He has told that it is a heinous expression of caste system, means it is the ugliest expression of caste system. And B.R. Ambedkar has told that untouchability, okay, so if we you can get the answer, means where did this untouchability arise? So you can get the answer for this question when you analyze the question, why did a particular group of people lived out of a village? Okay, so whether they had come from outside or they were pushed out of the village. So if we try to analyze the answer for this question, then we can get some information about what? The practice of untouchability. So this is told by whom? Your B.R. Ambedkar. Okay. Now, in the next part, I will share the screen for you now. Problems of untouchables or untouchability is a social level. How? Untouchability is a social evil. How? fourth. So you have got your textbook in your hand and I am sharing the screen for you also. How untouchability is a social evil? It is a big problem in the society. How is it a big problem? Okay, so untouchables, they were treated as the lowest strata in the society. You know, no untouchables problems. They were not allowed to use the wells and tanks of the tanks used by touchables. They were not allowed to use the cemetery used by the touchables. Here cemetery means a smashana. Okay, cemetery means what? Smashana. So they were not allowed to use the cemetery used by the touchables. They were not given education. Their children were not allowed to mingle with the children of touchables. They were not allowed to learn Vedas. They were not even allowed to recite or even listen Vedas. They were not allowed to learn Sanskrit. Yavade avakasha irlilla. They were treated very badly. They had no property right. They had not got political rights. Okay. They were not allowed to participate in the election. They were not allowed to even vote. So they faced many problems. I think you know all these points, but still you go through the points which you can find on your screen. So untouchables were treated as the lowest strata of the society. They were the lowest layers of the society. It is told by whom? Dr. Kuppuswamy. You have to remember this person's name. Dr. Kuppuswamy has told this. Okay. Then, how untouchables were treated? About this, you can get information in Manusmriti and Vyagrapada Smriti. Okay. So, problems of untouchables. There, in the first paragraph, they have given information about Manusmriti and Vyagrapada Smriti. So, in Manusmriti, if any touchable touches this untouchable, then he had to take bath. So that type badly they were, means that type of discrimination was there. Then in Vyagrapada Smriti, okay. So our muttugolbeku antanu illagittu. Cow's tail radius alli bandre, okay. So enadru andre ond aakla baadadashtu distance hatrake avaru nam touchables hatra bandbutidre. What they had to do? These touchables had to purify themselves by taking bath. Okay. So, in this way they were treated. And in the Malabar region. Malabar region means the coast of Kerala. Okay. In Malabar region, these untouchables, they had to prepare the footways. But they were not allowed to wear the footways. Okay. They had to prepare the footways. Chappalana or tayar madbekagittu. Bere avaru hakkollikke. ಆದ್ರೆ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಚಪ್ಪಲ್ ಹಾಕೊಳ್ಳಿಕ್ಕೆ ಅವಕಾಶ ಇರಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಹೌ ದೇ ವೇರ್ ಟ್ರೀಟೆಡ್. ದೆನ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಎಜುಕೇಷನ್. ಎಜುಕೇಷನ್, ಯು ನೋ ನೋ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್, ದೇ ಡಿಡಂಟ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಎಜುಕೇಷನ್. ದೇ ವೇರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅಲೋಡ್ ಟು ಎಜುಕೇಟ್ ದೆಮ್ ಸೆಲ್ವ್ಸ್. ವೇದಾಸ್ ವೇರ್ ಬಾರ್ಡ್ ಟು ದೆಮ್. ದೇ ಈವನ್ ಕುಡಂಟ್ ಲಿಸನ್ ಟು ವೇದಾಸ್. ಹೇಳೋದಲ್ಲ, ಕಲಿಯೋದಲ್ಲ, ಅದನ್ನು ಕೇಳೋ ಕೂಡ ಅವಕಾಶನೂ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಇರಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ about education I have told already. Then property right. They did not have, any right to own the property in their name. Avrige property ne property right irlilla agittu. Yavade aastiyanna avara hesaralli hold madlikke avakasha irlilla agittu. And finally, they didn't have any political right. Means they were not allowed to participate in election and they were not allowed to vote in the elections. Andre ಅವಾಗಿನ ಕಾಲದಲ್ಲೂ ಕೂಡ ಪಂಚಾಯತ್ದಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲ ಆರಿಸುವಂತ ವ್ಯವಸ್ಥೆ ಇದ್ದಿತ್ತು. ಯೂಶ್ ವೆರಿ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಫೈಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಇನ್ ವೇದಾಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ದ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ವಿಲೇಜ್ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಗಾಟ್ ದ ರೈಟ್ ಟು ಇಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ದಯರ್ ಲೀಡರ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಡೆಮಾಕ್ರಸಿ ವಾಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಇನ್ ಹಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ವಿ ಲರ್ನ್ ದಟ್ ಡೆಮಾಕ್ರಸಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಗಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಒರಿಜಿನ್ ಇನ್ ಗ್ರೀಸ್ ನೋ, ಬಟ್ ಇನ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ವೇದಿಕ್ ಪೀರಿಯಡ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಫೈಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್. ಸೊ with the help of these main points, you should be able to write some 8 to 9 points. Okay, 9 to 10 points for 3 marks questions. Very easy question it is, very general one, but you can expect 3 marks question or 4 marks question on this topic. So by writing 8 to 10 points, you can easily grab 3 marks in your examination. Am I clear? So once again, go through all the points there. So in this screen, you can find information about Vyagrapada Smriti and Manusmriti. Let us go for the next screen, fifth one. Yes. So here also you can find the points explained there. Once you go through all the points, I will repeat, children. In social studies, you are expected to write the answers in points. Points alli neevu eshtu barithiro ashtu nimma answer systematic aagutade, evaluator impress aagutare. I have a slogan, social studies means points anta. Okay, if you were in the classroom, I used to have this slogan in the class. Okay, so remember, you have to write the answer in points in social studies. Yes, do you have any doubt, children, in this screen? If you have any doubt, please raise your hand. Let me know if anybody wants clarification regarding any point there. Okay. So if you don't have any doubt, then let us go for the next one. Okay. So here, this B.R. Ambedkar. Again, we have to come for B.R. Ambedkar. Okay, so let us come for B.R. Ambedkar again. B.R. Ambedkar is the architect of our constitution. No? He is called the architect of our constitution. Then B.R. Ambedkar, being an untouchable, he has suffered the problems faced by untouchables because he too was an untouchable. He very well knew the difficulties faced by those people. That is why he worked hard for their development. So B.R. Ambedkar gave very much importance for education. He wanted the people to understand the importance of education, and he wanted the people to get education. So why education is so important? Why B.R. Ambedkar gave that much importance to education? I want to answer from your side. Why education is so important? Without education, what happens? I want to answer from your side, children. Think and raise your hand. Nobody is there. Huh? Why are you getting education then? Huh? Shri Harsha. Yes.
Mataji, because if we did not get education, there are a chance of cheating from others.
Exactly. Chances of cheating is there. Then what else? Why else education is necessary? Think and tell me. Rashmi?
By getting education, we can fight against exploitation.
Very good. We can fight against exploitation. Yes, then Rashmi, can you add some more points here? Okay, thank you, Rashmi. Pannaga, you tell me your point. Pannaga? Pannaga? Kavya. Kavya?
Yes, ma'am.
Tell me, why do you think that education is very important?
Without education, they can't own their property rights.
Okay. So education is very important. That too in democratic system. Okay. the people will have their right, people will have the right to fight for their or to own their own property or to work for their betterment. So this education helps us to demand social justice. Okay, so education helps us to think logically what right we have, what duty we have to do. Okay, so it makes us to think logically.
Education, we can difference.
Yeah, Pannaga, now you are answering. Okay, Pannaga, tell me. Pannaga? Okay, that is okay. So education is very important because it helps us to think logically. It helps us to demand for social justice. Okay, so it helps us for our welfare. That is why education is very important, and that is why B.R. Ambedkar and other leaders gave more importance for education. So B.R. Ambedkar always argued in the favor of education as a public property. Means everybody should get education. It is public property. It should not be restricted to a particular class of people. So again, one mark question you can expect. Who argued in favor of education as the right of public? Okay, education in favor of the education as public property. Who argued this? So it is this argument was made by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. One more question you can expect here. Okay, within 5 minutes this meeting may end. You have to rejoin the meeting when we send the link. Okay, now in the last part of the lesson we have to discuss about the constitutional and legal measures. What steps have been taken by our constitution to remove this problem of untouchability, and what are the other acts passed by our parliament to solve the problem of untouchability? Anybody knows which article of our constitution abolishes untouchability? Which article of our constitution declares that untouchability is crime? Right to equality. It comes under right to equality, fundamental right. Yes, anybody knows? Very important question from the point of view of your competitive exam also. Nutan?
Article 17.
Yes, exactly. You remember this article always. Not only for 10th standards exam, you remember it forever, okay? Article 17 of our constitution. So in your previous classes, you have learnt that Article 14 to Article 18 deal with what, children? Right to equality, no? So Article 17 abolishes untouchability and it declares that practicing untouchability is a crime. It is a fundamental right, okay? Article 17 abolishes untouchability. That is the first step taken by the constitution. Okay. Last speech. Last. Okay, sir. See the first point there. The steps taken by the constitution and other legal measures to eradicate untouchability. If the meeting ends, children, please rejoin. Now, Article 17, did you understand? From this lesson, very important articles and Article 20A and Article 17. Then afterwards, next important step in the government is...
Next important step in the government is...
Sudhanva, mute yourself.
Sudhanva.
Mataji.
Okay, so after Article 17, next legal measure by Indian Parliament is it has